By adhering to the principles of the seven SE mirrors, we can consciously reincarnate while retaining memories of past lives. The essence of these seven mirrors compels us to refrain from passing judgment, avoid blaming others, abstain from making comparisons, acknowledge the reflection within ourselves. During my youth, the term reflected mirror or reflective mirror was employed whenever I felt offended. I always found children's wisdom intriguing. The seven SE mirrors serve as reflections of unresolved issues or imbalances within us. Those who reside near or have close connections with us mirror these aspects. It is tempting to dismiss our feelings as someone else's problem, but in doing so, we deprive ourselves of the cosmic opportunity that the soul has co-created for our liberation. Hence, it is crucial to pay attention. First SE mirror. We receive what we give. Our actions are reciprocated. People and events are attracted to our lives based on our experiences, actions, and behavioral patterns. A victim not only attracts other victims, but also the perpetrator. A thief will draw in not just fellow thieves, but also law enforcement. A person who lives calmly and centered attracts others seeking a similar existence. Second SE mirror. We are measured by the same standard we use to measure others. What we judge in others manifests in our own lives. It is essential to refrain from judging to avoid being judged ourselves. Eventually, what we pass judgment on will appear in our lives. Third SE mirror. What we lack or have lost is mirrored in others. Everyone who possesses or embodies what we lack or has lost reflects that aspect of ourselves. For instance, if we admire someone free from the judgments of others, are we constrained by our fear of letting go of what keeps us imprisoned? Therefore, when we are drawn to someone and desire their company, we should contemplate what they have gained or lost. Fourth SE mirror. Fear of loss leads to loss. We create behaviors that cause us to lose sight of what is truly important to us. For example, those who solely prioritize their careers risk losing control over their families, genuine friendships, and personal time. Fifth SE mirror. Honoring oneself, parents, and the divine. Our relationship with our parents mirrors how we perceive the celestial mother and father throughout our lives. It also reflects our belief that our existence is meant to contribute to the community, our children, and more. Sixth SE mirror. Embrace challenges to activate the master within and learn. We always possess the capacity to confront any challenge that comes our way. These trials provide opportunities to learn and attain mastery. They test our growth and may even be the ultimate trial, the night of the soul, where we lose everything and must start anew. For example, if one loses both their job and family simultaneously, they are compelled to rely solely on their resources. Mastery is activated in such circumstances, where one finds themselves without any external support, and must rely exclusively on their abilities. Seventh SE mirror. Embracing perfect imperfection and recognizing perfection in all. The final SE mirror of self-awareness teaches us to seek perfection, even in the absence of apparent perfection. It involves learning to view our successes and failures without comparing them. Once we have mastered this mirror, we realize that failure is not an imperfection, but rather the best we could have achieved at that specific time, with the resources available to us. It is truly perfect. Comparisons and benchmarks set by others are limiting and imposed by external influences. Imperfection does not exist in reality. It is a deceptive construct fabricated by the mind. We, and only we, are the standard by which we measure our achievements.